She's the sassy songstress behind that catchy multi-platinum single where she's singing about her curvy bottom and all about that bass. But tonight, Meghan Trainor is out to prove that she's more than a one-hit wonder. With a new album about to drop, the 21-year-old dishes with my Nightline co-anchor Dan Harris about everything from middle school drama to whether she really hates skinny witches.
I'm all about that bass, no trouble.
Here's a funny story about Meghan Trainor. When she was filming this video for her Love Your Body As It Is anthem, all about that bass, she was actually feeling anything but comfortable about her own body.
I was like, this is what I wish I felt like. I wish I was all about the bass and all about my curves. And I was like, this is not how I feel.
Every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top.
Do you feel that way now?
Yeah.
Today, her whole universe has turned upside down. All About That Bass is one of the best-selling singles ever. The video has nearly 500 million hits on YouTube. The song has resonated with millions of people eager to feel better about their bodies, and it's also done wonders for the young woman who wrote it and sings it.
All my fans out there who tell me stories, they hated themselves and they weren't happy until they heard the song, and now they live a happier life. All because of a 3-minute song, and it's actually helped me. While singing this over and over again, doing the dance moves, feeling sassy, I walk off that stage like I'm a boss. I am Meghan Trainor. I look bomb, and everyone supports this right now.
Meghan Trainor, who just turned 21 a few weeks ago, has improbably become a pop star.
That's our tip, so make sure you check by every week on Clinique's YouTube channel.
We caught up with her filming a Clinique commercial the other day.
Eyeliner on top if you're feeling groovy.
And also performing a concert in advance of her new album, Title, which drops tomorrow. She never thought this could happen.
At some point, some guy said to you, I'll date you if you lose weight. Was that true?
I was looking real good that day. I was really confident. And he's like, oh, he'd be so hot if you're like 10 pounds lighter. And I was like, oh, I'm not gonna eat now because that was so awful. I was just very upset with myself, which I shouldn't have been because I was at Dorsey's. I was adorable. I should have loved myself, and I wasted a lot of years not, and I regret them. I didn't think I looked like a pop star because I was insecure, and I didn't think I had the body shape for it.
But by 13, she was recording her own music on GarageBand, the computer program.
I would show my parents, and they were very proud, and they're like, oh, that's cute. She has a good hobby. And I would beg them, like, yo, I need a tour bus. We should be on the road.
But success has not been all easy. The internet is flooded with spoof versions of her song, which make fun of her for allegedly hating skinny people.
I see good-looking skinny people. I think they should die.
Do you think there's anything to that criticism?
Do you hate skinny people?
I don't hate anybody.
I don't hate anybody. I have plenty of skinny friends. They stop listening after. Go ahead and tell them skinny bitches that. Because then I go, no, I'm just playing. I know even you think you're fat, but I'm here to tell you you're perfect.
From the bottom to the top.
But the most persistent question she gets is whether she can successfully capitalize on her newfound success.
Do you feel pressure to keep it going?
It's a piece of cake. I got it, because I got the songwriting down. I've already proven that I have 2 hits.
I know you're lying, 'cause your lips are moving.
That second hit, Lips Are Moving, hit number 5 on the Billboard chart. A good sign that this young pop star's career will not fizzle out. She's got perhaps the most important asset of all, confidence. For Nightline, this is Dan Harris in New York.